Hello, my name is Robert Bagwa Jr., originally from the Republic of Liberia. Before I begin, I would like to take this opportunity to extend my heartfelt thanks and appreciation to my big brother, Pastor Fumbat, for the invitation to be a part of this huge project. I also like to commend him for his work in Liberia to ensure that those in need of education gets them. I left Liberia when I was 14 years old. As many of us know today, our country went through a long, horrific civil war. That war left over 250,000 Liberians dead. Over 500,000 Liberians departed the country for their lives. In various countries, the United States and Europe, and some in Asia. I was one of those who came to America. And the first thing my father told me when I got to the United States was, this is a great country of opportunities. It's up to you to make use of them. The decisions that you make right now will determine your future. Understanding where I came from with little or nothing, I decided to be focused. I decided that education was the key. I decided that if I wanted to do anything in life, I needed to pursue my education, and that's exactly what I did. And so when I graduated back in 2010, we had a vision. We wanted to do something. We understood that the rebuilding process in Liberia needed all Liberians, not just the government, and not just those elected to serve the Liberian people, but the citizens. And I always remember the famous quote from one of my admirer, John F. Kennedy, when he said, "Ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country." I felt that every Liberian should be asking themselves that question. None of us have to be millionaires to give back. We can all give back with our time, our talents, and the little that we have. Mr. Fumbat being one of the blessed ones to have been able to escape the war and come to this great country and getting some of the best education as much as he could, prepare him to be in a position to help give back to his country. And I think his work is commendable. The needs for education in Liberia is very important. It's paramount. And it can't be stressed any further. I think education, as it has been said, is extremely important. It should be priority number one. Look, we have a staggering illiteracy rate at 85%. We have a staggering unemployment rate, and it's not a coincidence that we have an 85% illiteracy rate and an 85% jobless rate, because our people cannot just read nor write. And so education should be our number one priority. We should be fighting to ensure that every child who desires education in Liberia gets it. Not just academic education or formal education, informal education. We should also be fighting to ensure that those of our mothers and our fathers who, partly because of the war, have found themselves in some of the most difficult situations in life in Liberia today, we should also ensure that we enhance their skills. A lot of these parents have great skills. Some of them are great market winning because of what they did from that part of that life. They were able to send a lot of their kids to school today. Some of the fathers are great farmers, but they all need help in their respective fields. And so education is important. Just last year, I think just this year, we got a report from Liberia that over 25,000 students who sought for the University of Liberia entrance test all failed the test. And when I got that news, I wasn't so surprised because I think that was a proof of how badly or how damaged our education sector is. We have got to develop or invest in our education, not from the top down, but from the bottom up. I think a solid primary education system will reflect a successful secondary education. And to have seen 25,000 students who came from our primary education sector failing so badly for the entrance test, I thought that was just it wasn't a good reflection of our education sector, and it was a lesson to tell us we need to do better in that area. So to see our seeds for tomorrow taking up such a good initiative in education gives me a great privilege to be a part of this organization and the documentary. And I will ask you guys to really support the brother. We all can become CEOs and we all can be founders of something, but we all can find a credible organization like our Seeds for Tomorrow. And you have taken such a global initiative to push this down, to push this vision, to push this platform of what it is that he wants to do for Liberian children educationally. He has my support, given the fact that I work in the same area that he worked. I think it gives the opportunity for a great partnership.
Greatness. I see our next generation, our seeds tomorrow. Our seeds tomorrow. Look into their eyes. I see greatness. I see our seeds.
Look into their eyes. I see greatness. I see our next generation tomorrow. Our seeds tomorrow.